Thank you. welcome to the 95th Tap Day. And it's great to have this tradition back at Jesse Hall. And really, I want to thank the families, friends that are here to celebrate and support our students. For inductees, this ceremony marks a significant achievement. It shows appreciation and respect from your colleagues and from your faculty and staff, and a commitment that you have for our strong, strong values at the university. Each of our six secret society, honorary societies have its own proud history and tradition, and a legacy that supports student excellence and student achievement. Inductees have distinguished themselves in this classroom, in the community, and in every effort and every activity that they've participated in. And they've done that through their leadership, service, commitment to the community, but also academic achievement. Because of their hard work, they're now joining a long line, a very long line of distinguished leaders that have been tapped in years before. So we're very proud to celebrate their accomplishments as Mizzou Tigers and to thank them for their continuing contributions to their community and to overall to our society. Congratulations to all of those that are going to be tapped today. Thank you once again for joining us. It's going to be an exciting day where the reveals are going to be both surprising and well deserved. So it's now my honor to introduce Dr. Bill Stackman, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs. Bill.
Good afternoon. My name is Bill Stackman, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs and Dean of Students. It is my honor to be here with you and celebrate the 95th Tap Day in person. I'm so grateful to have this opportunity and to see your faces. We're here today to celebrate students, faculty, staff, and administrators for their extraordinary achievements and contributions to our campus. Not only have they found their way in, they have also lent us their light. These people stand out for their resilience, vision, and leadership. Resilience means they don't quit. It doesn't mean that they never fail. It means that when they do fall down, when they hit a bump, that they find the strength to get up again. They adapt. In this, they have been a lesson to us all, especially over the last 2 years. Vision doesn't mean they have all the answers. Only they ask the right questions. Vision means that they have the hope for the future and spread that hope so that we too may follow it. They are creative problem solvers. And leadership means they believe in the abilities and capacities of others. Their leadership brings us together and helps us recognize the humanity in one another. Under their leadership, we can achieve more than we thought was possible. We are inspired, we respect, and we trust. I know you will join me today in congratulating the inductees and in recognizing all of their contributions to the Mizzou community. It is now time to reveal the identity of this year's Tap Day inductees. A representative from each honorary society will make a statement about their organization and present their initiates. The first honorary to be recognized is Omicron Delta Kappa, ODK. Give that man a prize. ODK, 1933. Members are selected on the basis of leadership, scholarship, character, and service. Dylan Calhoun will be presenting the initiates.
The National Leadership Honor Society, ODK, strives to meet the goals of our founders to recognize those who have attained a high standard of efficiency in collegiate activities and inspire others to strive for noticeable achievements. The Society brings together the most representative students of all phases of campus life to create an organization that helps mold the sentiment of the institution on questions of local and intercollegiate interests. The National Leadership Honor Society, ODK, strives to meet the goals of our founders to recognize those who have attained a high standard of efficiency in collegiate activities and inspire others to strive for noticeable achievements. The Society brings together the most representative students of all phases of campus life to create an organization that helps mold the sentiment of the institution on questions of local and intercollegiate interests.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dylan Calhoun, and I am the current president of the Alpha Z Circle of Omicron Delta Kappa at the University of Missouri Columbia. I am thankful that all of you are joining us today. Omicron Delta Kappa, the National Leadership Society, was founded on December 3, 1914, at Washington and Lee University in Lexington, Virginia, by 15 student and faculty leaders. In the tradition of the idealism and leadership of George Washington, the founders formulated the idea that leadership of exceptional quality and versatility should be recognized, that representatives in all phases of college life should cooperate in worthwhile endeavors, and that outstanding students, faculty, and administration should meet on a basis of mutual interest, understanding, and helpfulness. The motives that guided the founders sprang from a desire to bring together in one body for the general good of the institution all leaders in the various phases of college activities. They were convinced that such an honor society, properly conducted, would offer maximum opportunities and experiences for the campus. It would also serve as a cooperative effort for more effective leadership and service in the purposes, interests, and needs of the institution, and for the maintenance and improvement of the unity and democracy of learning and citizenship responsibilities. On May 12, 1933, the University of Missouri Circle of Omicron Delta Kappa, the Alpha Z Circle, was founded. Since then, ODK has been recognizing students for excellence in five major phases of college life. First, scholarship. Second, athletics. Third, campus and community service, social and religious activities, and campus government. Fourth, journalism, speech, and the mass media. And fifth, creative and performing arts. ODK places an emphasis on the development of the whole person, both as a present member at the University of Missouri and as a contributor to a better society. Our TAPs understand that the self is truly a composite of the hand, the heart, the spirit, and the mind. And today, we will publicly recognize these members. Each year, Omicron Delta Kappa has the honor of welcoming new members into our circle. Every member undergoes a rigorous application process, which is completely blinded. Connections with current members do not provide applicants any advantage, meaning applicants must rely solely on their merit. This year, the Alpha Z chapter is happy to welcome 19 new TAP members and 2 honor TAPs to our circle. Despite attending college during unprecedented times, these students distinguished themselves as some of Mizzou's strongest and best leaders. We are honored to reveal them to you, and as we do so, we ask that you please hold your applause until all of our TAPs have been revealed. With that, Omicron Delta Kappa is proud to TAP a middle school English language arts education major from Jefferson City, Missouri, Braden Langendorfer. A political science, linguistics, and English triple major from Cole Camp, Missouri, Brooklyn Cross. A biological sciences and public health double major from Overland Park, Kansas, Calvin Winkler, who is unable to be with us as he is currently studying abroad. A journalism student from Wentzville, Missouri, Eleanor McCrary. A nutrition and exercise physiology major from Naperville, Illinois, Ella Bashensky. A mathematics and economics double major from St. Louis, Missouri, Gabrielle Hammond. a constitutional democracy and interdisciplinary studies double major from Jefferson City, Missouri, Hannah Watson. A music composition major from Liberty, Missouri, Isabel Borkhard. A biological sciences and psychology double major from Kansas City, Missouri, Julianne Lake. A journalism and music double major from Dexter, Missouri, Kate Wyman. A health science major from Bethalto, Illinois, Catherine Butler. A speech language and hearing sciences major from Imperial, Missouri, Lexi Jacobsmeyer. An accounting major from Defiance, Missouri, Matt Himmersmeyer. A political science and history double major from St. Louis, Missouri, Megan Charmitaro. A strategic communication major from Frisco, Texas, Peyton Parshu. An English and economics double major from Ava, Missouri, Reagan Swadesh. A journalism and Spanish double major from Naperville, Illinois, Riddy Undercar. A music and finance double major from Cape Girardeau, Missouri, Sam Varnin. A journalism and parks and recreation and sport double major from Keller, Texas, Sophie Zell. Please give a round of applause for our student TAPs. We also have two honor TAPs, which we hope to recognize as part of our 2022 TAP class, who were selected by current members for their contributions to the student community. These individuals exceeded what is required of them in their service to the Mizzou community. First, Associate Dean for Undergraduate Studies in the College of Arts and Sciences, Dr. Nicole Monnier. Dr. Monnier graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Russian from Mount Holyoke College in 1991. She went on to receive her PhD in Slavic Languages and Literatures from Princeton University in 2000 after defending a dissertation, which was a reception study of the critical and cultural legacy of the first Russian literature critic during a period of cultural repression in Russia. Her current research focus is mid-19th century Russian prose and criticism, and she arrived at Mizzou in 2000, working as a faculty member in the College of Arts and Sciences School of Languages, Literatures, and Cultures. As a teaching professor of Russian, she teaches courses that explore the intersection of literature, culture, and history of Russia, while promoting career readiness for both undergraduate and graduate students. But Dr. Monnier is not known on campus just for her accomplishments. She's also known for her impeccable character. Her support of students pursuing big goals and advocacy for those who have needed it has undoubtedly impacted the lives of numerous students on campus in profound ways. ODK is grateful to have a faculty member as exceptional as Dr. Monnier join our circle this year. Second is the Director of Intercollegiate Athletics, Ms. Desiree Reed-Francois. Ms. Reed-Francois pursued undergraduate education at the University of California, Los Angeles, where she graduated from in 1994. 3 years later, she earned a Juris Doctor from the University of Arizona College of Law in 1997. Since then, Ms. Reed-Francois has acquired more than 25 years of experience in intercollegiate athletics. Her leadership has impacted numerous programs across the country before she joined Mizzou Athletics in the fall of 21. As the first female athletic director at a public institution in the SEC and MU history, she is a trailblazer that represents the best of Mizzou. This falls in line with her previous accomplishments, including being the first Hispanic female and woman of color athletics director at the football bowl subdivision level. In just her first year at Mizzou, Ms. Reed-Francois has already changed the culture of Mizzou athletics for the better. Assisting in the recruitment and hiring of new coaches, working diligently to enhance student participation in athletic events, and supporting our student athletes in unprecedented ways are only a few of her many accomplishments. ODK is eager to see the progress Ms. Reed-Francois continues to make in the years to come, and is honored to have her join our circle so early on in her Mizzou career. ODK is proud of this 2022 TAP class. We are grateful for all that they have contributed to the university and the greater Columbia area, and are honored to have them join our circle today. We look forward to seeing what they accomplish in the remainder of their academic career and beyond. Once again, congratulations to the Omicron Delta Kappa TAP class of 2022. We are all so lucky to have you. Thank you. All right. Get together for the photo. Photo.
The next society to be recognized is LSV. LSV was formed in 1908 by a group of women students who were concerned with the status of women at the University of Missouri campus. Quiescence Bassett will be presenting the initiates.
Formed in 1908, LSV was created by a group of women concerned with the status of all women on the University of Missouri campus. LSV is dedicated to improving the status of women and is a high honor bestowed upon those who embody LSV ideals.
In 1908, Mizzou's campus was forever changed by the founding of LSV. Concerned with the status of women in the political climate, LSV was created to assure that the rights and needs of women were cared for and protected. As Violets in LSV, we always aim to support and uplift women. African Violets go strong due to their roots. Black trans women have been the roots and foundation of Black culture and society. When they are mistreated, we, the Violets, will take up for our sisters and respond. In light of the accomplishments of trans women constantly being overlooked, I would like to take time to recognize and honor revolutionary trans activists who deserve their flowers. Marsha P. Johnson, a trans activist and one of the leaders during the Stonewall Uprising of 1969. She was also a co-founder of STAR, Street Transgender Action Revolutionaries, who support and provide housing for queer youth and sex workers in Manhattan. Ms. Major Griffin Gracie, a trans activist who speaks out against the prison system, which disproportionately incarcerates transgender individuals. Andrea Jenkins, the first openly transgender Black woman elected to public office in the US in 2017. Not only serving as the council president, she also writes, performs poetry, and is a trans activist. Many Black trans women have been at the forefront of movements acting as Violets to ensure the betterment of a diverse number of communities. Regardless of the light, beauty, grace, and activist work done by Black trans women are disproportionately impacted by oppression. Our sisters are unjustly criminalized, face housing insecurities at high rates, and are victims of violence due to race and gender discrimination. There is a horrifying pattern of anti-Black violence against Black trans women. Black trans women are violets, still growing and thriving in communities stricken of anti-Black transphobic violence. I urge everyone here to check their privilege and reflect on ways which can better support Black trans women. You can donate to the Gabriella Rose Justice Support System, an organization that supports trans students and their educational goals at the University of Missouri. You can find them and donate on Facebook by searching for the Gabriella Rose Justice Support System. Now, it is time to introduce the newest TAP class. It is a privilege to have served as Vice President and have the honor of introducing the LSV TAP class of 2021 to 2022. Each of our TAPs this year is a leader in their own right, and I am extremely excited to reveal their identities to you all. Without further ado, I present to you the LSV TAP class of 2021 to 2022. When we select our violets, each year we look for women who embody an honest heart for service, a true understanding of sisterhood, and lastly, a woman who does not need or seek recognition for her service in sisterhood. Given so many unforeseen circumstances over this current year, I am very proud of our newest class of violets. They have persevered through the pandemic, and I am in awe of women that can do it all and do it well. Our first violet is a senior from Jefferson City, Missouri, majoring in psychology and biology. This violet brings logic and a sophisticated voice into all rooms that she enters. She wants to mitigate health disparities within her field as a physician. Her light and beauty makes it a great honor to present Violet Pooja Halder. Our next violet is a senior from Maryland majoring in journalism. This violet brings insight and a new perspective to different parts of campus. It is an honor to present Violet Lauren Carlton. Our next violet is a junior from Bartlett, Illinois, and majoring in journalism with an emphasis in strategic communications. This violet brings laughter and life to spaces that she enters. This intelligent and driven violet is on the path to finish an accelerated master's degree to strengthen and better the IDE initiatives for social media companies and advertising and sustainability practices. It is an honor to present Violet Amari Foster. Our next violet is a junior from Kansas City, Missouri, majoring in Black Studies and Political Science with a minor in English. This violet carries herself with a graceful presence. Her intelligence is at the forefront of so much important work at this campus in a humble and true manner. This violet plans to obtain a PhD in Africana Studies and eventually become a professor with an emphasis in historical films and documentaries. It is a great honor to present Violet Andrea Brown. Next, it is time to reveal our honor TAPs. Our first honor TAP serves as the director of the Relationship and Sexual Violence Prevention Center. Not only does she work at the directorial level, but is also pursuing a doctorate while raising two outstanding children. This violet is a dedicated and inspiring changemaker. She ensures that her dedication to student mental and emotional health changes the lives of students affected by systematic and social injustice. It is an honor to present Violet Katrina Sardis. Our next honor TAP is an assistant professor of Black Studies and Women's and Gender Studies. Among many accolades, this violet has been awarded the 2022 Catalyst Award. This violet is a change maker in education. She researches history, current conditions, and concepts surrounding Black women, feminism, queer studies, among other research areas. And in addition to obtaining this knowledge, this violet also shares this knowledge through her teachings. This violet helps to ensure that the environment surrounding Black women is a community of educated individuals. It is an honor to present Violet Christina Carney.
Alrighty. Our next society to be recognized is Mortar Board. Mortar Board began in 1915 as the Friars Club, an honorary organization for women. 3 years later, the Friars Club aligned with Mortar Board, a national women's honor society, though now it includes students of all genders. Emma Perry will be presenting the initiates.
Beginning in 1915 as the Friars Club, Mortar Board is an honorary organization for women. 3 years after its founding, the Friars Club aligned with Mortar Board, a national women's honor society, and now it includes students of all genders.
Hello, everyone, and thank you for being here today. My name is Emma Perry, and I have the honor of serving as Mortar Board's president this past academic year. Mortar Board Honor Society was built on three central values: scholarship, leadership, and service. The incoming TAPs are individuals who exemplify these qualities at the University of Missouri campus in ways that are both seen and unseen. The past 2 years have been an incredible challenge for individuals around the globe and on college campuses. There's been staggering grief, turmoil, but also remarkable resilience and compassion within the human condition. Today's individuals are bearers of candles that light the dark and ignite within every corner of campus and the community. I speak for the Mortar Board chapter as a whole when I say these TAPs are the best of us, and we are of the firm belief that they will continue to uphold the values and improve the legacy Mortar Board has stood for. Without further ado, I am pleased to present Mortar Board's first TAP, Grace Nielsen. Grace is majoring in social work and is from Joplin, Missouri. On campus, Grace is involved with It's On Us, advocating for sexual violence prevention, and the Mizzou Status of Women Committee and the tour team. Her recommender describes her as an individual with unwavering dedication to do the work, and perhaps, most importantly, unflinching kindness that extends to all. Grace Nielsen. Our next tap is Roman Rowe Liebhart. Roman is involved with the National Alliance of Student of Black Educators, Words of Thanks, the Dorsey Leadership Project, and as an Eagle Scout. Roman is described as ambitious, with a thirst for knowledge and genuine passion that extends to all experience. Congratulations, Roman. Yeah. Presenting Mariah O.K. Thomas. Mariah is majoring in business administration with an emphasis in marketing from Springfield, Missouri. On campus, Mariah is involved with Alpha Kappa Psi, Making Strides Against Breast Cancer, and Missouri Student Media. Her recommender describes her as an energetic professional in her volunteer work. Welcome, Mariah. Our next tap is Chloe Brewer. Chloe is a social work major from Cahokia, Missouri. Chloe is involved with Mizzou Alternative Breaks, Alpha Phi Omega, and student research through the Honors College and School of Social Work. Her recommender describes her as a personable, diligent, and outstanding and accomplished student. Congratulations, Chloe. Our next tap is Lauren Bain. Lauren is an elementary education and political science major from Chesterfield, Missouri. Lauren is involved with the University of Missouri's Residence Hall Association, Pan-Hellenic Association, and the Kinder Scholar Program. Her recommender describes her as a conscientious and dedicated student, and more importantly, a supportive peer and a reflective leader. Congratulations, Lauren. Presenting Jordan Walters. Jordan is a business administration major with an emphasis in marketing from Richardson, Texas. Jordan is involved with Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Alumni Association Student Board, the Mizzou Black Women's Initiative, and the True Lask Study Abroad Office. Her recommender describes her as an advocate who isn't afraid to speak up and an individual who actively seeks out relationships with others. Congratulations, Jordan. Our next tap is Allie Pig. Allie is a secondary education major from Columbia, Missouri. Allie is involved with Mizzou Circle K, the Teacher Education Student Advisory Committee, Alumni Association Student Board, and the Griffiths Leadership Society for Women. Her recommender describes her as an individual with great passion and enthusiasm whose service and commitment has been a huge impact on the student body. Congratulations, Allie. Now presenting Katie Jennings. Katie is a health science with a pre-professional emphasis with a minor in business and psychology from Bates City, Missouri. Katie is involved with the School of Health Professions Student Council, Phi Delta Epsilon Medical Fraternity, and Caring for Columbia. Her recommender describes her as altruistic and a dedicated individual. Congratulations, Katie. Presenting Tobias Davis. Tobias is an accounting major with a minor in psychology. Tobias is involved with the National Association of Black Accountants tour team and a True Lask Excellence at Mizzou mentor. His recommender describes him as genuine, humble, and yet confident individual who has a lot to contribute to any program or group. Congratulations, Tobias. Our next tap is Catherine Corley. Catherine is an accounting major with a Spanish minor from Leawood, Kansas. Catherine is involved with the Mizzou Homecoming Steering Committee, Alpha Kappa Psi Business Fraternity, and Pi Beta Phi Sorority. Her recommender describes her as unwavering, always accountable, and advantageous to new opportunities. Congratulations, Catherine. Now presenting Addison Whisker. Addison is a woman and gender studies and sociology major from Union, Missouri. Addison is involved with Mizzou Alternative Breaks, Women and Gender Studies Advisory Board, and is a resident advisor. Addison's recommender describes her as kind, helpful, prompt, and has an affect for social change that will continue beyond her college years. Congratulations, Addison. Our final tap is Alexis Seals. Alexis is a social work major and is involved on campus with the Black Pre-Law Student Association, Council of Student Social Workers, and Mizzou Alternative Breaks. Her recommender describes her as persistent, dedicated, and an individual who handles challenges in stride while maintaining commitment to her values. Congratulations, Alexis. The Mortar Board Friar Chapter is also pleased to present three honorary TAPT members. Honor taps are selected by the chapter and recognized for their dedication, involvement, and passion within the Mizzou community. Our first honorary tap is Andrea Jackson. Andrea has occupied many spaces on campus, first through the Study Abroad Office and now serving as a student support specialist in the GOBCC and multicultural centers. Andrea truly cares for the student body and makes an impact in every place she occupies on campus. She is a source of light and inspiration for all, and we are honored to present her as a Mortar Board honorary tap. Our next honorary tap is Lindsay Hing. Woo! Lindsay is an exceptionally inclusive leader serving as the Assistant Director of Business Career Services within the Trulask College of Business. Lindsay goes out of her way for every student she interacts with. She's passionate and advocates for all students as an integral force of implementing more inclusive and equitable practices in workforce recruiting. We are honored to present her as a Mortar Board Honorary Tap. Last but certainly not least, our final honorary tap is Kate Elmore. Kate has had numerous roles from her time here as an undergrad to her current role as a coordinator of recruiting for the Trulask College of Business. Kate is one to speak up when things need to change in recruitment while also supporting future, past, and present Tigers. She is passionate about Mizzou and seeing it grow into a better place. We are honored to present her as our final 2022 TAP class recipient. What? Picture.
Next society to be recognized is QEBH. QEBH is the oldest honor society at the University of Missouri. Founded in 1898 by Royal Hill Switzler, Omo Eke will be presenting the initiates.
Founded in 1898, QEBH is the University of Missouri's oldest honor society. Dr. Royal Hill Switzler sought a select group of students who would contribute to the university's well-being, to promote the university and to constantly be on guard on her behalf, Switzler said.
Hello, everyone. So the current president for QEBH cannot be here today, so I'll be standing in for her and introducing these wonderful taps. Disclaimer, after I announce each name, feel free to yell as loud as you possibly can, all right? It's gonna have fun. As best said by Muhammad Ali, friendship is the hardest thing in the world to explain. It's not something you learn in school, but if you haven't learned the meaning of friendship, you haven't really learned anything. To the TAP class of 2021, Rachel, Zaria, Dimitri, Kate, Dre, and Mackenzie, you all have taught me the greatest lesson I've learned to date, leadership through friendship. Change is inevitable, but true. Systemic change comes from the gathering of friends with the hope that we leave this place better than we have found it. Through the act of love and care, you all have pushed the spaces you are in and the friendships you hold to be the best they can be. Not for yourselves, but for the betterment of all of those around you. It is through this love and care that you all have shown me these acts of goodwill don't just do nothing, but they get passed around to others as well. Your fervor for friendship and your urge to do the right thing bleed into spaces you will never see, but will forever be changed. Thank you for loving this university deeply, because it is through this love that we fight for change. Thank you for loving each other deeply as you have created a space of accountability, support, and camaraderie like none you have ever had before. Lastly, thank you for loving me and showing me this love because I will forever be changed by this family you all have created. Now to the new TAPs. This year's TAP class comes from all walks of life, and this is what makes QEBH so great. Through their intentionality with their friendships, leadership, campus involvement, and how they lead through life, these TAPs have demonstrated what it means to do the right thing, even when it might not be the most popular choice. By advocating for sexual assault survivors to ensuring the retention of Black and Brown students through community building, the TAP class of 2021 has full confidence in the new class to continue the legacy of standing on guard on behalf of the university and her students. While swimming upstream is not the easiest of tasks, this class is more than capable to handle any trials and tribulations that may come their way with the utmost grace. Sincerity, generosity, integrity, magnetism, courageousness, resilience, and impactfulness. These are just a few of the traits that these TAPs embody with their leadership. Under Rachel's guidance, I know that QEBH will grow like never before. Now let's get started. From Columbia, Missouri, and majoring in nutrition and exercise physiology with an emphasis in human physiology and translational sciences, our sophomore TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to Mizzou Tour Team, Muslim Student Organization, and the Kafner Inclusion, Diversity, and Equity Committee. As the future president of QEBH, she is described as a force of positive change within the world. She is altruistic, focusing her energy on helping those around her and leaving every room she enters better than how she found it. She loves her community deeply, treating them like family. She is an ally to all, always willing to lend a helping hand and to highlight the work of others. Please welcome Sadia Momita. From Overland Park, Kansas, and majoring in journalism, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to It's On Us, Beta Chi Omicron, Mizzou Student Foundation, Kappa Alpha Mu, Agricultural Communicators of Tomorrow, Journalism Ambassadors, and is a National Press Photographers Association student representative. He is described as a truly good person through heart and action. This TAP will speak truth, act with truth, and stand for truth. He is not afraid to think with his heart because by following his heart, he will then stand with his conscience, morals, and values. Please welcome Matt McCabe. From Chicago, Illinois, and majoring in biomedical sciences, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to being the Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated Programming Chair, Residential Life, Pre-Med Society, Mizzou Black Women's Initiative, MAPS, Mizzou Global Brigades, and the Griffith Leadership Society. She is described as a quiet storm because she only has to say a few words, but those words will be heard across the room. She is someone who, no matter who is watching, stays true to her ideals and morals. She works hard to pull back in order to push forward in the hopes of improving the lives and uplifting the lives of all students on campus. Please welcome Camila Lucas. From Jefferson City, Missouri, and majoring in biology, pre-med, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to Beta Theta Pi Fraternity, Homecoming Steering Committee, the Alumni Association Student Board, Pre-Medical Society, Open Door, and the Missouri Orthopedic Institute. He is described as a ray of positivity wherever he goes. He dedicates his time investing into his campus organizations while also consistently being a caring friend to all of those around him. His impact can be felt across campus and by all those he encounters. Please welcome Daniel Ray. From Havana, Cuba, and majoring in nursing, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to LBC Gospel Choir, is the Global Brigade's Outreach Chair and Public Health Brigade Leader, and ALAS member. MAPS member, a tutor through A Way with Words and Numbers, a food bank volunteer, and MedZoo volunteer. She is described as a true woman of character. She is honest, dependable, and the epitome of a public servant. Her genuine nature and dedication to leaving this world better than she found it is what sets her apart from her peers. Through her dedication to service, she has proven that she knows what it means to give herself while seeking nothing in return. Please welcome Deborah Paez Perez. From St. Louis, Missouri, and majoring in economics, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to being a previous residential advisor, a teaching assistant for Mizzou Black Men's Initiative, MPHC Public Relations Chair, and is a chapter president of the Beta Tau chapter of Iota Phi Theta Fraternity Incorporated. He is described as a friend and leader that will always listen first, being a mentor for Black students across campus. This TAP always puts others before himself and sets the standard for leading by example. Please welcome Keyshawn Russell. From Collierville, Tennessee, and majoring in secondary education, social studies, this TAP has dedicated their time in undergrad to Pi Beta Phi and Tour Team. She is described as someone who cares tremendously for the individual persons in her life. When she engages with those around her, friends or strangers, they consistently leave feeling heard, seen, and loved. We expect this TAP to act as the catalyst that keeps QEBH joyful and always smiling. Please welcome Cameron Peterson. And now on to our honor TAPs. Our honor TAPs were chosen for their benefits and efforts that they have provided to the Columbia community as a whole, as well as the University of Missouri. From Kunming, China, this TAP has dedicated her career and life's passion to seeing students thrive in their academic and personal lives. As an academic advisor and now a coordinator for Summer Welcome, she has demonstrated a fervor for student support. She is described as an amazing soul. Whatever choice she makes, she does it with the best intent for her students. Throughout her life, she has displayed the ability to overcome obstacles, and with that, her experiences are inspiring to students and her direction is trustworthy. She is truly the definition of a role model. Please welcome CG Yao. From Chicago, Illinois, this TAP is the definition of leading with your heart and soul. A two-time Tiger and four-time staff member, this TAP has made great strides to improving Mizzou's campus climate through his passion to serve students of all backgrounds. Through his work in residential life, he has shown student leaders the importance of knowing when to do the right thing, even when others do not see what you do. Not only that, but he has served as a lifelong friend to his brothers in Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, 06. And has demonstrated to students, faculty, and family what it means to lead through understanding and love. He is described as a force to be reckoned with. His leadership and mentorship serves as the outline of what it means to lead through friendship and intentionality. Please welcome Deontay Boyd. I'll add another one. There you go. From Portland, Oregon, this TAP is a definition of what it means to teach from heart to heart, not head to head. She has been a Presidential Engagement Fellow, received the Provost's Outstanding Junior Faculty Teaching Award, and was a 2020 William Kemper Fellow. Along with these achievements, her work has been noted in a PBS, BBC documentary, a Netflix documentary, published several journals and abstracts detailing her research in biological anthropology. She is described as boundless, breaking down any barrier that stands in her way. She strives to promote honesty and understanding and champions the rights of others. She is a force for good within the academic world and is a role model for all those who meet her. Please welcome Dr. Libby Cowgill. Give it up for him again, please.
Our very next society to be recognized is Rollins Society. Established in 1994 by the University of Missouri Graduate and Professional Council, Rollins Society recognizes outstanding professional students and graduate students. Jessica Osage will be presenting the initiates.
Established in 1994 by the Graduate Professional Council, the Rollins Society honors graduate and professional students at MU who have significantly advanced the well-being of self-defined communities beyond the scope of their academic work. Each of these TAPs has made contributions above and beyond the expectations of graduate students, and each of them embodies, through their actions, our society's watchwords of duty, faithfulness, and leadership.
Our first TAP is Ashley Anderson from Atwater, Ohio, a doctoral student in English. Ashley is an active member of the creative writing students community. Her nominator describes Ashley as publishing essays at a breakneck pace. But beyond her academic successes, Ashley serves in multiple leadership roles that enable the social and professional development of graduate students at Mizzou. Representing grad students at faculty and college meetings regarding graduate student climate, a noteworthy accomplishment is her work in petitioning for a 12-month pay option for graduate student pay. Ashley is equally committed to undergraduate education and mentorship, specifically undergraduate women, through her role as Assistant House Director of Pi Mu Fraternity. Ashley's peers highly regard the leadership she displayed during the pandemic and praise her genuine care for others. Writing, her calm exterior belies her ferocious commitment to communities, making her work look effortless. We welcome Ashley to the Rollins Society. Our next stop is Malaika Folaimore from Columbia, Missouri. A doctoral candidate in nursing and a successful researcher with an NIH grant, Malaika has assisted her department in promoting open communication between students and faculty and designing value-added experiences for students. One such experience was leading doctoral students, postdocs, and faculty to participate in a one read of White Fragility and the New Jim Crow, Mass Incarceration in the Age of Colorblindness. As a seasoned public health nurse, Malaika's civic leadership extends across campus and her community. Having served as a lead COVID disease investigator for the Columbia Public Health and Human Services Department during the pandemic and working in school-based influenza clinics. Finally, Malaika's support of refugees integrating into the Colombia community spans 15 years, with significant work with Rwandan women survivors of the 1994 genocide. Epia describes Malaika as in a league of her own, and by a nominator as maintaining high dedication to service. As a graduate student and promising nurse scientist whose work will change the world for the better, we welcome Malaika to the Rollins Society. Our TED Talk is Glenn Gilliott from New Orleans, Louisiana. A doctoral student in organic chemistry and an outstanding teaching assistant, Glenn is a recipient of the College of Arts and Science Green Chalk Teaching Award and serves as an adjunct professor at William Booth University. Glenn's accomplishments also reflect a commitment to inclusive excellence. As a graduate scholar of excellence, Glenn mentors undergraduate students from underrepresented groups who are interested in STEM graduate programs. As a coordinator for STEM, COBS, Glenn leads initiatives to expose and engage kindergarten through fifth grade students to STEM fields, even designing a successful virtual program with at-home activity kits during the pandemic. One nominator wrote of the hundreds of students, their families, and their communities who will benefit from, for years to come, the seeds that Glenn so joyfully plants. We welcome Glenn to the Rollins Society. Our fourth tap is Corey Johnson from Wooshan, Ohio. A master's student in journalism, Corey exemplifies how one can successfully bridge professional work and personal convictions, serving as an associate producer for a national investigative television unit. Corey's supervisor praises his passion for solution-based journalism that identifies the change agents taking on the overwhelming system that perpetuates systemic barriers to the impoverished. Corey's research with the 2021 Hunger Project is praised by the Feeding Missouri program and a service to the unhoused, food insecure, and impoverished populations is described by another nominator as a humble duty and moral obligation to serve vulnerable populations through his daily life that is nothing short of remarkable. Just a glimpse into Corey's accomplishments includes caring for Colombia, a weekly volunteer and ambassador for Tiger Pantry and Truman's Closet, and as a multi-year leader of the homeless and poverty-focused Mizzou Alternative Break Trip. Welcome, Corey, to the Rollins Society. Our fifth tap is Johanna Mylord from New York, New York. A doctoral candidate in counseling psychology, researching vocational psychology, Johanna works to promote inclusion, diversity, and aid for students of color, including racial, ethnic minorities, international or low-income students. A member of the Graduate Scholars of Excellence inaugural class and a co-facilitator of the Healing from Racial Injustices group, Johanna is also a founding member of the Graduate Women of Color Collaborative. Johanna spends most hours of involvement with the Africa Hub and African Graduate Professional Students Association, where she has held leadership positions and coordinated events, including a panel for African faculty to share their professional journeys. Johanna's creation of a Friendsgiving dinner for over 90 students on Thanksgiving Day has become an annual event. Each spring, Johanna uses her choreography and dance skills to coordinate the African dance portion of Africa Fest. Described by a nominator as a servant leader with unlimited potential, Johanna works to help gild the social capital of others, as well as a well-developed sense of duty and a faith in humanity. Johanna, we welcome you to the Rollins Society. Our sixth top is Anne Obadan from Edo State, Nigeria. A doctoral candidate in public affairs, Anne's nominators describe her as an advocate for the welfare of graduate students at MU, be it professionally, financially, or socially. Through increasing leadership responsibilities in the Graduate Professional Council, GEPC, Anne mentors new board members in ways that are above and beyond. As GPC's Director of Professional Development, Anne works closely with the graduate school to provide workshops while also running the GPC Writers Readers Room. Anne launched a fundraising event that generated over $3,000 for GPC to support grad students who are experiencing financial hardships, and coordinated a virtual game night to create connections among students during the pandemic. Anne also initiated a new award in GPC known as the Research Development Award to support students' research and creative scholarly activity. A faculty member writes of Anne's curiosity, intellect, and motivation, while peers write of Anne's solidarity and empathy of her neighbor. Having already left a mark on the Mizzou community, we welcome Anne to the Rollins Society. Our seventh top is Kanishka Siklegar from Hyderabad, India. A doctoral candidate in chemistry, Kanishka serves as a graduate welcome leader for incoming students each fall, going beyond the expectations of hosting weekly meetings to assist with the transition of graduate school. A nominator describes Kanishka as a voice for international students and for all graduate students. Prior to the pandemic, Kanishka was acutely aware of the stresses associated with graduate school, and his work in this area increased through COVID. Serving on the Mental Health Task Force through GPC, Kanishka now serves on the Graduate Student Mental Health Task Force with the graduate school. A beloved and awarded teaching assistant, Kanishka is often seen meeting with and advising undergraduate students and has connected with the Columbia community through science outreach programs for Boy Scouts and a Magic of Chemistry program for middle school Girl Scouts. An undergraduate student writes that Kanishka is generous in his support and concern for others, always doing so with a persistently positive attitude towards life. Welcome, Kanishka, to the Rollins Society. Our eighth and final graduate student tab this year's class of Rollins Society is Emma Wickland from St. Louis, Missouri. A master's student in public health, Emma has supported projects centered on LGBT research, HIV research, and a team studying COVID on campus. A faculty member writes that Emma is destined to be a future leader in public health. A peer describes Emma as the author of many policies supporting women's advocacy, ability rights, queer visibility, and awareness of chronic illness within populations inside and outside of Mizzou. Her impact can be seen through Emma's work with campus organizations like GPC and OutGrad's Queer Outreach Program, and beyond campus as a board member of the Missouri Public Health Association, along with St. Louis University, Washington University in St. Louis, and Missouri State. Her chief nominator writes of Emma's passion about public health and supporting underserved and vulnerable communities. We welcome Emma to the Rollins Society. Our first honor top is Lionel Phillips, assistant teaching professor in public health. Lionel's work experience also includes the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and the Missouri Department of Health and Senior Services. Lionel also coordinates the MPH internship program and was an instrumental part in creating the university's Show Me Renewal plan during the pandemic. We are grateful for her service and for the opportunity to welcome Lionel to the Rollins Society. Lionel couldn't be with us today. Our second tap is Dr. Stephanie Shonekon. Senior Associate Dean of the College of Arts and Science, co-director of the Michael A. Middleton Center for Race, Citizenship, and Justice, and a professor of music and black studies, a constant champion for the humanities and the fine arts, Dr. Shonekon is also a constant champion for students, an active leader on campus and in the Columbia community. She works tirelessly, yes, always optimistically, to create an inclusive culture that focuses on student success. For this reason, we are proud to name Stephanie a member of the Rollins Society.
Last but not least, the final honor society we'll recognize today is Mystical Seven, one of the university's oldest honorary societies. Mystical Seven recognizes and promotes leadership, service, integrity, and scholarship. Taylor Estrica will be presenting the initiates. Thank you.
One of the oldest societies, Mystical Seven, recognizes and promotes leadership, service, integrity, and scholarship. They honor students and faculty of remarkable character. It's a place for those who will pursue uplifting platforms instead of things that are popular for a short moment. The people of Mystical Seven seek goodness, not because it is loud, ambitious, or popular, but because being good is fundamental to a mystical being.
This year's Tap Day marks the 115th year of Mystical Seven's public existence, and we are honored to be here before you all today with another wonderful class of individuals. Before I name the new members of Mystical Seven, I would like to take a moment to address the Mizzou community, who has faced so much change over the past few years of uncertainty and trauma. I would first like to recognize our student body. We have seen a campus that so many of us were growing to love become something that feels tense and in many ways incomplete. With the pandemic, change in leadership, restructuring of our social justice centers, and the mass exodus of Mizzou's employees, specifically Black and Brown employees, we know that our communities are feeling a loss of connection and support. We want to recognize our student body for the resilience they have shown while continuing to march, educate, and advocate for progress, although that responsibility should not fall on the shoulders of marginalized students alone. We see you, we hear you, and we truly thank you. In addition to our student body, we speak to our chancellor, board of curators, and state legislature. If this event were taking place on this stage some 72 years ago, not a single person standing up here today would have been allowed to attend Mizzou, much less be recognized in this way. Much like the 1950s, Black and brown individuals have had to continue to fight against the oppression of the university into the present day. It might not be today or tomorrow, but one day, the bandages that you all continue to sloppily apply over this university's race, class, and other identity-based issues as a means to silence our voices will be ripped off. In the words of Kurt Vonnegut, you can't fight progress. The best you can do is ignore it until it finally takes away your livelihood and self-respect. Without further ado, the individuals that I'm about to announce are being revealed both as a thank you for their great deeds to our community, but also as a call of arms to continue doing their good work throughout our campus and beyond. This junior tap is a student of vibrant creativity, the essence of a team player and a trailblazer who shines in any space she enters. She stops at nothing to provide support to those around her and leads while holding out a hand to anyone who might need assistance. I present to you Bailey Sims. Studying film studies with an emphasis in production from Kansas City, Missouri. Bailey is passionate about fostering community in the arts in all facets. Thank you, Bailey. This next junior tap is a scientist and scholar who has shown unwavering dedication to the success of his community members as he moves through our campus with the fearlessness that inspires and impacts those around him. I present to you Justin Aguda. Justin is passionate about establishing strong connections, creating memorable moments, and spreading happiness to those he encounters. Thank you, Justin. This junior tap is willing to stand up for what is right, despite any odds they may personally face. They shed a light of love that is warm and unapologetic to their communities. This tap has a desire to grow and challenge the status quo, often setting themselves apart from other leaders who elect to play it safe and agree with our university's often oppressive administration. I present to you Ari Ellis. Is a junior studying psychology with a minor in Black Studies from Kansas City, Missouri. Ari is passionate about fighting racism, especially within the LGBTQ plus community. Thank you, Ari. This next junior tap helps others find a beacon of hope within themselves and has shown a level of humility that all of us can learn from. Is someone who makes change for the better simply by existing as his unapologetic self. Let this tap serve as a reminder that it is okay to be yourself no matter who is watching. I present to you Ogechi Adika. Ogechi is a junior studying business administration from Kansas City, Missouri. Ogechi is passionate about spreading love to any and everyone he encounters because of the love God has shown him. Thank you, Ogechi. This junior tap understands that while it is easy to succeed on your own, one must carry others with him on his path to success. Being a first generation and transfer student on our campus, this tap recognized that succeeding would not be easy. With his willingness to build up others around him, he has become a pillar in many communities for people to lean on. I present to you Stephen Miller. As a junior studying computer science from St. Louis, Missouri, Stephen is passionate about providing others with knowledge and resources to ensure they can lead the life they deserve, knowing the world often fails to acknowledge their intrinsic value. Thank you, Stephen. Our final junior tap is someone whose words are changing the world around her. She has the ability to take her lived experiences and transform them into beautiful works of poetry that she continues to share with the rest of the world in a battle to be the voice for the voiceless. When we look at this tap, we see someone who has taken control of their fate to lead with vulnerability. I present to you, Marjay Neal. Marjay is a junior studying journalism with an emphasis in editing and production from Kansas City, Missouri. Marjay is passionate about the power of words and a strong advocate for art therapy. Thank you, Marjay. Now I would like to present our sophomore tap. This tap will lead the Mystical Seven family during the 2023-2024 school year. This tap is a refreshing and passionate person who has shown dedication to both community and progress, and we believe that his optimism and insightfulness are imperative to our campus. His ability to be intentional in his interactions remind us all that leadership can be transformative if the people in charge are leading from the ground up. I present to you Bryson Ferguson. Bryson is a sophomore studying business administration with an emphasis in management from McKinney, Texas. Bryson is passionate about uplifting others through creating spaces where people can thrive. Thank you, Bryson. Now, I would like to introduce you all to our honor taps who serve our campus in many professional capacities. This first honor tap has impacted the lives of people on this campus and shifted what their time at Mizzou could look like for the better. Her commitment to supporting underrepresented students on this campus has created a legacy that flourishes beyond the walls and ceilings of her office. I present to you Honor Tap Ana Maria Fernandez. Ana Maria is a student service coordinator within the case office. She is passionate about serving and supporting student success while assisting them to achieve their goals during their journey at Mizzou and beyond. Thank you, Ana Maria. This next honor tap has dedicated the last decade of her career to advancing inclusion, accommodations, and accessibility for people with disabilities at Mizzou and beyond. She is someone who shows up to the campus community with enthusiasm, passion, and most importantly, kindness. Thus, Honor Tap has been planting the seeds that foster conversations that can lead to our campus becoming a more accessible environment for all. I present to you Amber Cheek. Amber is the Director of Accessibility and ADA Coordinator for the Office of Accessibility and ADA. She remains passionate about the inclusion of people with disabilities and believes that should be a priority for everyone. Thank you, Amber. Our next Honor Tap is a multifaceted and inspirational feet-on-the-ground type of change maker. She has shown up to underrepresented communities to teach students about well-being and packs a punch with artistic style that conveys stories which reveal the goodness that is at the core of her personhood. I present to you Benny Sebastian. Benny is a PhD candidate in counseling psychology. She is passionate about bringing mind, body, spirit practices into the classrooms of higher education and believes in applying a holistic approach to learning and well-being that can create a compassionate campus community where all feel seen, heard, and valued. Thank you, Benny. This last Honor Tap is an advocate for education access. He is dedicated to the well-being of marginalized students on this campus and has shown his goals for enhancing the Black community through the power of love and education, oftentimes creating a home on our campus for students who would otherwise not see themselves remaining here. I present to you Joel Stanton. Student Service Coordinator with the Pathways to Success program. He is passionate about supporting the retention, persistence, and graduation of Black male students from K through 12 through post-secondary education. Thank you, Joel. Please join me in one final applause for the 2022 TAP class of Mystical Seven. Into our mystical family and continue to embody the mystical mission for the remainder of their lives. Thank you all once again and enjoy the rest of Tap Day.
Once again, once again, Thank you so much, family and friends, for being with us today. Congratulations, initiates. As we close the 95th Tap Day, I have a word to next year's initiates, many of whom I think are with us today, either in this room or online. At this moment, societies near and far continue to be challenged. To meet these challenges, we need your resilience, your vision, and your leadership. My advice to you is collaborate. You can achieve more by working together. Raise each other up and celebrate one another's successes. Serve the greater good. Focus on the growth and the well-being of your communities. Take care of your people. And hold on to hope. Don't be discouraged by the difficulties you see around you. Be the light to those who need it. So once more, thank you. Thank you all for your contributions to this campus community. I am looking forward to all the good you continue to do today and tomorrow. In closing, MIZ. Thank you very much. Have a great day.